I know the one that'll work, I don't have, it won't fit, so I can't use that one. I got a real nice arbor here, but it won't fit. And this one I think is too big to even get started in the hole, because I don't want to make the, I don't want to make the hole any larger, I just want to make it longer. And the perfect one won't fit. It'll fit the drill bit though. It'll fit the drill. And it'll fit the drill out there. And you know what? Before we go nuts, let's try it here. This ain't gonna be fast enough, but it'll give me an idea. And if it does anything here, I might be able to make it work out there. Okay, what I wanna do with this is come, which way do I wanna go here? This way. This may do it. If this would fit the milling machine, I wonder. Try to grind this down. Well, actually, I tried to sand it down and I couldn't because, I mean, this is good stuff. Now, this is an old chuck. I'm wondering. Now, if I try to drill that out, it's just going to spin. So that's not going to work. All right, so the only way this is going to happen is out there. So you want to come with me, guys? Let's try this again. See if I can get you to move without turning you off. I'm going to use the press. I mean the drill press. I guess I can make it. Turn the light on. Key. I got to paint this key. Orange or something. Keep losing it. Now, what did I just do? Oh, here it is. I said, okay, what did I do? Lose that already? Do I have it? Do I have it? No, these are all big. Even my sanding block. This does fit in here, so I don't have to worry about that not fitting in there. Oh, in a hurry, because I knocked that off today. Let me put this little belt on up here. There we go. Thank you. might have been easier to do the other piece because the other one's thinner. Want to have the ability of being able to slide this a little bit if in fact I feel necessary to give myself a little room. And I think it would be nice just in case the blade is off of here. A little bit more. See, it would have been easier to take it off of this because it's thinner, but this is it. Let me go just do this real quick. Yeah. All right. I think that's going to give me what I needed. I want to be able to... See, it could have been just slide this, but I want to have this pivot point pretty secure. I don't want to take a chance in having it move on me. I don't mind if I want to make an adjustment with this. Okay, let's see. You know, once that's pivoted and locked in, I can move this to adjust that. Perfect. Okay. Now, so I want to, let me grind this up a little bit. Wrong one. need to clean this side. I'm getting ready to do this. I was just thinking of something. Quite a few years ago, the wife and I bought a one-family, 14-room one-family home. And I need some heavy duty stuff here. So let me use this. There was a 14-room one-family, three-story home. I'm looking for something to put on here, so hold on a minute. I don't want to just get a bunch of glue. There we go. And we turned it into a legal two-family. The wife and I did it ourselves, so it wasn't super expensive because we did all the labor. So it ended up with a brush or something. I don't want to ruin that right now. We ended up spending about $35,000. You know, because we had to put in a separate service. We needed two 200-amp services. I ran all the wires. I just had an electrician, a licensed electrician, come in to put the boxes in and to hook everything up. And I said, as long as I'm running wires, I ran all new wires for both the first and second floor. I didn't utilize any of the old wiring. And I put some 220 in the basement. It had the old stone basement. And we made it a legal two, like I said. So whole new services, 200 amp. New furnaces. Again, if I'm replacing one for the second floor, I might as well replace the first one on the first floor too. So new furnaces. The second floor furnace was more, was larger.
Echo Alpha, waiting for next first contact.
Because it was heating up and air conditioning. Two floors instead of just one. And then we had to run all new ductwork. Well, seeing that we were running and separating the rooms and the walls and the hallways, I had to put new walls up here and there anyway, so running the ductwork wasn't a big deal. Going up, throwing the heat out, I used 3x, I forgot what it was, regular duct work. For the return, however, I ran, I just ran it between the studs and I just put some flashing in there, you know, because it was a return, so I just didn't want a lot of crack to get thrown in, but again, I didn't have to run ductwork. I could have just ran an insulated foil type paper if I wanted to, but I wanted to do it right. So we did all that. And then plumbing. I had to add Well, actually, two bathrooms. The third floor had a bathroom, but it was a half bath, and it was fine, so I wasn't going to go nuts with it. The second floor was where the bath was, the original full-size bathroom for the whole house. And then they had just a room downstairs with a toilet off the kitchen for somebody who had to go to the bathroom. So we put in a full bathroom downstairs, almost a complete new bathroom on the second floor. The third floor we left it alone because it was in good shape. It had a sink. It had a shower, actually. And naturally the toilet. So now, I was going to say something. That's how I was getting into this, because I was setting it up for something. And now I forgot what the hell I was setting it up for. It had something to do with the sanding and the epoxy, the